So I've been thinking about getting a coastal rowing boat for a while now, and I finally did it. So today I'm going to show you my first row that I took my coastal rowing boat out. You can see here it's sitting on top of my car. I've just got some kayak roof racks and they seem to be pretty good. Seems to distribute the load well enough. The biggest problem with these boats is that they're just so heavy. I guess they're made tough to survive well out in the surf and open water, but they're 36 kilos. So when you're used to picking up a 14 kilogram single on your shoulder, 36 kilos is a whole new ball game, and it's really barely just manageable with one person. And as you can see here, I'm just sort of shifting it about, trying to work out the best way to hold it. Although I found later on that if I take the two bungs out, it can be, you can hold it relatively well. They make pretty good handle holds. And although I can carry it along on my hip like this, it's not very comfortable. I find it best on my shoulder. So it takes a bit of effort to get it up there, but if you're in the right spot, you can sort of balance it nicely there. Although you do definitely get a good workout doing it. So this coastal rowing boat that I've got, I think it's made by Leo Coastal Rowing out of Sweden. Interestingly enough, it's got a foot stretcher that was made in Tasmania and shipped over to Sweden, then went to New Zealand, I think. Coastal Rowing New Zealand, the previous owner who had it before me said that it crossed between the North and South Islands on a journey of New Zealand, so I thought that was pretty interesting as well. And as you can see, I'm just trying to place it here. It's got a fin that's in the center at the back there, and I didn't want to put too much weight on that because I know it's quite a heavy boat, but it seemed to sit into the sand relatively well and seems to be pretty solid. But even still, just trying to make sure that it doesn't snap, because it's quite a heavy boat. So I just got my GoPro 360 on the rigger there, just a little backstay that I've shortened that works pretty well for it. So I brought my phone and my keys and a little case for the GoPro, as well as a spanner, and it's got a little compartment in the center there. It is watertight, generally speaking. I do believe it is. The phone is water resistant too, so I'm not being totally brave by putting it inside the this watertight cubby hole, but I think it's relatively good. As you'll see a bit later on, I undid it while I was out, had to tighten something, and because the boat sort of fills up with water a little bit when you're stationary, I actually filled that whole cubby hole up with water, and so that's a bit of a trap for young players. So the oars I'm using are just a set of old Concept 2s, which I used to use in my single, my flatwater Wintec single, and I thought that they'd be good for this purpose. I don't mind too much if they become damaged, but I don't think, unless you flip the boat or something like that while you're out in the surf, and it would probably be damaging, could be damaging. So if you've got a keen eye, you'll notice here that I put my gate in the wrong way on this side, on this stroke side, and I only worked that out once I hit the water. I guess doesn't matter how many times you've done it, you can still make that simple mistake. One thing I'd definitely be more careful of next time I take it out is getting sand in the boat, especially on the slides, because it becomes absolutely full of sand, and I realised that when I hit the water. I'm not quite sure how to get around this design feature, but there's a grab handle at the front of the boat which can be used for dragging it along the sand, but the fin is the fin digs straight into the sand, so I guess maybe if you're rowing without a fin, that might be useful. You can sort of twist it on its side, but it's hard when you've got the oars in there. You don't want them to fall out, so in the end I decided just to pick the end of the rear of it up. Although you could probably force it into the water forwards, it's not ideal as the bow digs in, so I just thought I'd pick it up and reverse it into the water. The sand is probably going to, if you did this all the time, wear out a small part of the front of the boat. So I generally recommend, if you are thinking about getting one of these, or you can borrow one, get two people, So I think it's a two-person job, these boats, really, unless you have some sort of trailer. But if you're getting it on and off in a car, I'd definitely recommend having two people using it. So as you can see, the stern part of the boat is nice and open, so basically it'll drain. It's designed to fill up with water and empty instantly, basically. So, alright, so yeah, just try and clean a bit of the sand out of the slides. They're probably not great having it like that, and so yeah, just be careful when you maybe give them a wipe out with your t-shirt or something before you go out in the water. It would make it a lot easier. So yeah, I'm just about to realise that I've got my gate in backwards. Obviously something you'd like to get fully prepared before you go for a row if the waves are coming, but today it was nice and calm, so it wasn't such a big deal. But yeah, something didn't feel right, and yep, there it is. Got it round the wrong way. Too much of a hassle. Another thing with this boat is it's incredibly stable, even just like hanging out the side of it, and you'll see when I get into waves and things, I never felt like I was going to tip out. It'd be an ideal boat for learning how to row in, not necessarily at a beach, but if you had a on a flatter bit of water, you could definitely do that. I found the foot stretcher and the shoes really comfortable. They're made out of some sort of foam-like rubber, and yeah, just having bare feet, I didn't even think that I'd need socks or anything. The only thing I'd probably change with this boat when I got rowing is I'm particularly inflexible with my calves and Achilles tendon, and having relatively long shins and poor flexibility, it makes it quite difficult to get to the catch. But you know, this boat seems to move really quite quickly, and I was quite surprised at how well it runs. So it probably took me about, I don't know, 5 minutes out there before I thought I should be catching waves with this instead of just going up and down the coast. So I just sort of caught a little half one there, it hadn't broken yet, just to sort of see what happens. And one of the things that the boat does, I'd recommend if you're going to catch a wave, getting out in front of it. So you sort of use the speed of the wave to sort of propel you forward. Just stay out in front of it, especially if it's going to break. I found that when I got the stern end up on the peak of the wave and the bow down at the base, it would dig in. And once it digs in, it starts to turn. And no matter how hard you check the blade, it's pretty hard to stay straight. So yeah, I think probably just getting out in front of it is probably the best way to go. If you had some nicely breaking waves, you could probably go across it relatively easily. It does have a tendency to want to do that. So yeah, just sort of having a play here. It catches pretty much anything. You know, being I think 5.6 meters long, it's extremely easy to catch waves, and it turns around really quickly too. Yeah, spins around quite quickly. It's very stable. So this is probably the biggest wave I caught. I think it was the second wave that I did. I had pretty much no idea what I was doing. And yeah. So even though the wave broke on me, I sort of leaned into the wave a bit, but the boat still felt incredibly stable. I guess I have the added benefits of the oars, which can be used to keep the boat stable, but it knocked me off my seat. Like, I sort of floated off my seat as the wave crashed over me, but that wasn't too hard to fix. You see those little waves breaking, pretty much had absolutely no trouble going into the waves. So like, the bow is extremely buoyant and pierced through it, but yeah, I could just launch myself at pretty much any wave on this day. Maybe it got to 2 feet, 2.5 feet. I don't know what it would be. Probably a bit more scary in bigger stuff, but I'd have pretty good faith that you'd be able to get out relatively easily. You've got plenty of momentum and you can build up plenty of speed. So I realized that my one of my pins was loose. Here's me trying to tighten it with just a shifter. I probably needed two things, but if I gave it a little bit, yeah, did manage to tighten it up, and I thought, you know, I should probably tighten the other one up, but it seemed not to move too much. But yeah, it's probably worth checking. First time I drove the boat, so I thought it was tight, but obviously not enough. You can see here that the boat's sort of filling up with water from the stern, and it just sort of laps in there. And right under my knees there, that watertight compartment I have that's got that bag in it is currently filling up with water. So yeah, I look back about now and realize it's totally full of water, including my phone, totally submerged. Done the exact opposite of what I wanted to do, keeping that compartment dry. So I thought, even though my phone is water resistant, you know, it's an iPhone XR, I think. I went back in and tried to empty it out, got my phone out of the compartment before I went out again, thought I could tighten bits and pieces up as well. So I'm not sure what the general protocol is for trying to get these boats out of the water. This just sort of seemed to make sense for me, instead of taking the oars out separately, which you could do. If you had two people, would probably recommend taking the oars out, but because it wasn't too rough, and this seemed to be a pretty logical way to do it. Just point the bow into the waves in case anything bigger came along, but yeah, I didn't really have any trouble. I mean, the boat was a fair bit heavier and harder to grab onto when it was full of water and wet, but yeah, it seemed to work okay. See, even like this, some of it still drains out, but yeah, fatigue definitely sets in pretty quick when you're trying to grab something with no handles that's full of water. So yeah, definitely, I might consider taking the fin out. It didn't seem to do an awful lot for keeping the boat straight during waves, and I'm not sure how it would behave without the fin in it. I guess it's probably doing quite a bit, even though it doesn't seem like it is sometimes. But it'd be a lot easier on the beach if it didn't have a fin. You could just drag it along the sand pretty easily. I reckon it would put up with that. And yeah, just trying to tighten these pins up a little bit more. Not the easiest thing to do with one shifter, but you know, it works okay. See, I'm not getting too much done there, but yeah, eventually got it to a point where it was nice and tight and wouldn't move. Obviously I didn't have anything to measure it with at the time, so I just sort of eyeballed it, tried to make it the same as the other one. And yeah, I think for what I was doing out in the surf, you're probably not going to notice it very much. I've got no idea what this rig should be set up like. I suppose you have to, you know, maybe have a bit of a practice, like no idea what the span should be or what the oar should be. I mean, obviously it's a bit heavier, but from what I understand, the coastal rowing races are often sprint races anyway, so you might just deal with that similar gearing to what you have on the flat water. But yeah, I bought this as a bit of fun, not necessarily for competitive use. So that compartment, although it's probably very good at keeping water out as well, it's very good at keeping water in. You could have quite a nice little esky in there, I'd imagine. And even, you probably need a sponge to get all the water out. Even turning it upside down, I struggled to get all the water out of it. Yeah, I probably should have paid a bit more attention to the backstay. You can see it just bent there when I did that, but, you know, no big deal. The GoPro and the backstay survived all right. It probably just has a little bit less life in it now. So when I got back out, I thought I'd go catch some few more waves, tried a few different techniques. So basically once you catch a wave, I tried checking the boat. This is limited effectiveness, and as you can see, when the wave catches up to you, the boat fills up with water, which I'd have to say is probably not ideal. You do stay a lot more straight and don't get forced sideways like I did on that first wave. As you can see, sort of here coming out to the waves is quite easy, quite enjoyable, bouncing over them, even crashing through them a bit later on. So yeah, this using this boat, like there were a few surfers there with, 9 foot mouth, something like that. They were struggling to catch anything, whereas you just turn this boat around, any hint of a wave and you can catch it. It's really quite fun. Yeah, you can see it's a smaller wave. Wasn't not even close to breaking, but still catching it very easily. And now it starts to think about breaking and I'm trying to sort of get off it before it does. It worked okay. Yeah, you can see here I'll come in, out, turn around nice and quick, come straight back out to the breaking waves. And yeah, the waves crash over the front, the bow shoots through it, shoots up in the air. You get a bit of water in the boat, but before you even take the next stroke, it empties out. So that's really, really not a big deal. Now, get out, 3 or 4 strokes, turn around really quickly. That's one of the good things about rowing. Normally you have to look around to know where you're going. With this, you're sitting there perfectly, facing the right direction to catch a wave. You get to see the wave coming. And it couldn't be much better, really. Obviously, though, you don't get to look forward when you're catching it. So yeah, here I practice sort of going out in front of it. You can see here I'm in much more control. The boat still picks up heaps of speed, but I've not got the problem of getting turned sideways, and in the end it was my choice to get off that wave before it got too shallow. So yeah, I think that's probably the technique that's to be used, especially with bigger waves, I reckon. Just so that bow doesn't get forced into the water. So here I'm just waiting. I want to see if I can get plow out through a big wave or a bigger wave. Just waiting for a good one. All right, I think I've got something. Can I hit it as fast as I can? Yeah, wave broken, you just shoot straight through it. It's really good fun. And there's absolutely no worries about the capability of the boat. It seems really buoyant and solid, stable. I wouldn't have any hesitation trying to take it out through waves a lot bigger. I'll have to do that when I become brave enough and the swell's right. This one I'm just trying to sort of steer it by checking on one side. You can see the boat filled up with water as the wave crashed over the back. It's like on a little spa bath, but it didn't work so well. But I guess there's plenty of ways to catch waves with this thing, and it seems to put up with pretty much everything. I didn't get tipped out once. I imagine if you do get tipped out, it would be not ideal, especially trying to recover the oars. So anyone who's fallen out of a single will know that the oars don't always sit in the right spot and can easily get caught under the boat, and that's not very good if there's another wave coming in 10 seconds. I found it very, very stable. Yeah, lots of fun. Definitely can't wait to take it out again. But yeah, I think I'll get another person to help me just because it is so heavy. I have to admit, I definitely pulled some sort of shoulder muscle trying to carry it and put it on the car. Wasn't too bad. And again, if you start trying to check it, boat fills up with water, it works okay, but I reckon if you're trying to win a race, you probably want to just be rowing out in front of it, just using the wave building up behind you to get the extra speed, and try not to get caught up in the white water. So this is my last wave, and as you can see, I'm rowing quite hard just to stay out in front of it. Have heaps of control. The boat's going where I want it to. Still got tons of speed, and I recommend that's the way you should go about catching the waves if you don't want to get put side onto them, which objectively could be fun, but also increases the chance you'll just get rolled by it. Luckily that didn't happen to me today, but who knows what it'd be like with bigger surf. Probably a lot more scary. So yeah, if you got the chance to go for a row on a coastal rowing boat, especially on the coast and the waves aren't too big, just nice little ones, I'd highly recommend it. It's a lot of fun. Yeah, obviously they're also good for harbours and things where the water gets kind of rough, too rough for a standard single. But yeah, I think they definitely enjoy being on the coast, and yeah, you'll have a lot of fun doing it.